The shimmering golden wrath of the heavens made flesh. Paladins deal merciless justice to the sworn enemies of order. In this video, we're going to share to paint these models. We're going to paint them in the colours of the Hammers of Sigma. We're going to be following the classic method and painting them up to battle ready. But the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Retributor Armour, which is perfect for the Hammers of Sigma colour scheme. Now, the first colour we're going to be applying is a shade, and it's been Reichland Flesh Shade Gloss. So I'm going to be using a medium shade brush for this. All I'm going to do is apply a little bit to the palette. This isn't to water it down. All I'm doing here is just so I don't overload the brush too much. So once I'm happy with that, I'm ready to start applying it to the model. So all I'm going to do is just start coating over all the gold armour. If you get it on other areas, don't worry so much, because we'll paint over that at a later stage. And the reason for using the gloss paint is to maintain that nice shiny golden armour. There we are, that shade now applied and dry. We're ready to move on to the next step, which is to apply a base paint. Now for this, we'll be using Cantor Blue, and it's for its armor panels or pauldrons and the trim on his tabard as well. So I'm gonna use a medium layer brush for this. All I'm gonna do is just apply a little bit to my palette like so, a little touch of water just to thin it down so it's not too thick and goopy. Get a nice point to the brush and then we're ready to start applying it. Like I said, we'll start on the pauldrons first. So he's got two, one either side. So all I'm gonna do is just start applying that on. In some places, you might have to do a second coat. For most of it, you should only need one. And of course, you then got the trim on the tabard just around here to do as well. There we are with the Cantor Blue now applied. What we're going to do now is move on to applying the rest of the base coats. Now we're going to start by using Rakar Flesh for any parchment areas. After that, we'll use Celestial Grey for any white details. For the silver areas, we'll be using Lead Belcher. For his black leather, we'll be coating that in a Baden Black. For his red plume, we'll use Mephiston Red. And finally, for his weapon haft, we'll use Screamer Pink. But first of all, let's start with the Rakar Flesh. I'm just going to give the pot a quick shake. Pop it open and then we're ready to start applying it. So what I'm going to do is just get a little dollop again like we did previously, a little touch of water like so, and then we're ready to start base coating. So the only parchment on this model is just on the back where his little cartouche is. So all I'm going to do is just start applying that. And again, you might want to do a couple of coats of this. There we are with the parchment now done. What we're going to do now is use Celestial Grey to pick out the lightning bolts on the symbol. With the lightning bolts now picked out, we're going to move on to picking out the silver details. For this, we're using Lead Belcher. So you're painting the hammerhead and his scale mail tabard. Again, you might want to do a couple of coats of this as well. With those silver areas now picked out, we're going to move on to applying the black to the black leather. So for this, we're using a Baden Black. And it's all like the soft joints between the armour as well as his belt. With the black leather now done, we're going to move on to painting the plume. And for this, we'll be using Mephiston Red. With the plume now done, we're going to use Screamer Pink to pick out the weapon haft. With all those base coats now applied, what we're going to do now is move on to applying a shade, and this is going to be Norn Oil. We're going to coat this over all those areas we just base coated except the gold, because that's already been done. So I'm going to use a small brush for this. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, again, not to thin it down, just so I don't overload the brush too much. Get a nice point, and then we're ready to start applying that on. So I'm just going to start on the haft and just work to those other areas after. With that shade now dry, we're ready to move on to applying some texture. And for this, we'll be using Aglan Badlands. So I'm going to get my trusty texture tool, start with a large scoop first. So all I'm going to do is just scoop some of that out, like so, onto my scoop, and then we're going to apply it to the base. So all I'm going to do is just dollop a big lump like that onto there, like so, and then use the smaller side just for a bit more accuracy and get it around those feet. Now, once it's all applied, you want to leave it for around about an hour to dry. And when that's dry, just paint the rim of the base in the colour that matches your army. And for this, we're using Steel Legion Drab. There we are, with the texture now dry, our paladin is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paint, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later stage. Also, when using shade paint, try not to overload your brush, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle ready paladins. And we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.